Welcome back everyone to Formula One 2020, round 5 of the season, a historic Grand Prix, the 70th anniversary Grand Prix, celebrating 70 years of Formula One. It's our second race in a row held at Silverstone, the venue of course, for the first ever race in Formula One. As you can see, we're slowly heading towards the mid phase of our calendar. The Spanish Grand Prix is next weekend. The Spanish Grand Prix in the middle of August, goodness me, that should be carnage. But this weekend, it is the second of those two races in the UK. After the Russian Grand Prix, we've also got three Grand Prix announced last week: Imola, Portugal, and also a return to Germany. Last season, you would have seen Lewis Hamilton claim a 6th Formula One British Grand Prix victory. It was Bottas in 2nd, Charles Leclerc in 3rd, but last time out, things were a little bit more interesting. Lewis Hamilton claiming a 7th victory here at Silverstone. However, it wasn't quite that straightforward. Teammate Bottas was 2nd for the majority of the Grand Prix, but several late tyre failures sent Carlos Sainz way out of the point. Lewis Hamilton also had a final lap tyre failure, but however, limped home over the line with 3 wheels. The first time in F1 history a driver has finished with a puncture. Victory for Hamilton, a comfortable lead at the top of the standings. Max Verstappen inherited a 2nd place, what could have been a victory for the first time in 2020. Charles Leclerc got his 2nd podium of the season. And after that crazy result in Silverstone, your Drivers' Championship looks like this. Lewis Hamilton has got a 30-point lead over teammate Valtteri Bottas, whose closest challenger is to 3rd man Max Verstappen, who's just 6 points behind the Mercedes driver. Lando Norris is still holding on in the top 4. Leclerc is rounding out the top 5. Albon, quite a bit off his teammate, he needs a good result this weekend. Perez, Stroll, Ricciardo and Carlos Sainz, your top 10. Your bottom half is filled with drivers looking to get a big result this time out. Last time it was a fantastic race for Ocon and Gasly, their 11th and 12th, the two Frenchmen. Sebastian Vettel, an unlucky 13th for him at the moment. Raikkonen, Latifi, Russell and Grosjean yet to score. Your team's championship looks like this. Mercedes have a comfortable lead, 146 points for the reigning world champions. Red Bull are in P2, McLaren a 3rd, beating Ferrari. How many people would have said that at the start of the season? A fantastic points haul from Renault last time out jumps them comfortably now into 6th place, only 10 points behind Racing Point. Williams, the only team yet to score, but 12th place last time for George Russell. Maybe that could change this weekend. Your Formula 2 standings looks like this. No points for Robert Schwartzman last time out in Silverstone, but still holds on to the lead. Callum Ilott, though, after an impressive showing in the feature race, closes the gap now down to 8 points. Lundgaard is 3rd. Mazepin, his first feature race win, jumps him up to 4th. Dan Ticktum, with his first sprint race victory, is up to P5. It's Schwartzman and Lundgaard, the top of your rookie standings. Tyres, a big topic of conversation last time round. I think it could be even bigger this weekend. Bit of news in the newsroom in a little minute about tyres this weekend. However, we do have softer compounds. Last week, it was the hardest option at all. C1, C2, C3. We're going one grade softer this time round, folks. C2, C3, C4. Two stop surely is inevitable. Perhaps even 3 stop strategy is going to be the best it's been for so long. I cannot wait. And your weather, just to make things even spicier, Friday, Saturday and Sunday, all expected to be some of the sunniest conditions we have ever had for a British Grand Prix. 29 degrees expected for Friday, 26 and 24 on Saturday and Sunday respectively. There is a 40% chance of rain on Sunday. It's Silverstone, never count it out, but this should be a clean race. Strategy will be key. Right, shall we crack on with the rest of the show? Starting off with a hot lap, celebrating 70 years of Formula One. Welcome everyone to your lap through time, your hot lap for the Formula One 2020 70th anniversary Grand Prix. Where better place to start than the 1988 McLaren, the most successful Formula One car of all time. Ayrton Senna partnered Alain Prost, drove this to his first ever World Championship. Through Turn 1 and through Turn 2, crucial for Sector 1 as we now fade into our second car off the hot lap, the 1992 Williams. Nigel Mansell piloted this lovely, lovely looking car, one of my favourite liveries of all time. As we head onto the Wellington Straight, this will be one of the most crucial parts of qualifying, but down towards Loughfield and Woodcote as we head into the Benetton 1994, this is going to be overtakes galore during the Grand Prix. This offboard shot of another very, very sexy car indeed. Michael Schumacher's first World Championship in the Benetton as we head over to his last World Championship winning car, the 2004 Ferrari. Heading to Copps, modern cars can do it flat out. This one, though it sounds so, so lovely, slight lift through Copps corner. And now we head over to the 2006 Renault, through Maggots, through Beckett, and finally through Chapel. Again, modern Formula One cars almost flat through there, and to our penultimate car of our lap through time, one of my favourites, the 2009 Braun GP. Jenson Button piloted this to his only World Championship. Didn't win, never actually won at Silverstone, but a man who did, Lewis Hamilton, last week's winner, did it on three laps, but in our hot lap through time today, we'll do it on all four, through Club Corner, through the final corner, and that is your lap through time for the 70th anniversary Grand Prix. Moving on over to the newsroom, not much to report this week. Obviously, we've only had a week since the last Grand Prix. However, there are three stories I've picked out which should be interesting heading into this weekend's race. And of course, that big story we didn't have time to talk about last week, Nico Hülkenberg is back. The German driver had less than 24 hours to fly over to Silverstone, jump in the car, first practice, second practice, qualifying, and bless him, he didn't even get to do a single lap in the Grand Prix. He is set to return this weekend unless the FIA changed the rules slightly to accommodate a return for Sergio Perez. Unlikely though, Hülkenberg should compete in his first race for Racing Point since 2012 this weekend. Fingers crossed, all goes well for the Hulk. McLaren have made a driver signing. They have signed Paul de Rester. Don't worry, this isn't to replace Norris or Sainz. Their reserve drivers are currently the Mercedes drivers. However, with Gutierrez unavailable, with Hülkenberg now at Racing Point, and Van Dorn at Formula E currently in Berlin, McLaren had no options if either of their drivers was not able to race. Hence, they have signed de Rester, who last raced in 2017, replacing Felipe Massa at the Hungarian Grand Prix. A solid replacement if they so need it, but fingers crossed it shouldn't have to come to that for the McLaren team. And your final bit of news, nothing too concrete, but Pirelli have come out after last weekend's chaotic tyre events during the British Grand Prix and said this weekend they will be changing tyre pressures compared to that of last weekend's British Grand Prix. We're still sticking with the softer compounds, which should mean we have at least two or three stops, but it's their way of just controlling things and making things a little bit more easier to read going forward. Only time will tell. With hotter conditions this weekend, I still think it's going to be crazy. And that is it from your newsroom this time round. Not a lot to report, but that is the nature of back-to-back-to-back Grand Prix. And now, moving over to what is one of my favourite segments of the weekend, prediction time. This weekend, I've gone bold. I'm expecting, you can probably already tell, I'm expecting crazy strategies. I'm expecting safety cars. I'm expecting a hell of a lot, that's for sure. So fingers crossed, it's an absolute belter of a Grand Prix. And in a minute, I will give you your grid to do your predictions. Throw them in the comment section below and the most liked will be featured in tomorrow's video. And no, don't put Hülkenberg first just to get likes. Ah, go on then, if you really want to. But here is my predictions for this weekend's Grand Prix. I've gone with a Lewis Hamilton pole position, a Valtteri Bottas P2, Mercedes lockout, of course, with Max Verstappen P3. Those three were comfortably the top three last time out and I don't see that changing in qualifying. But in the race, I told you I was expecting a crazy one. I've gone with a Lewis Hamilton victory. He is just a bit too good around this place. And I think after last time's moments at the end of the race, I think at least one side of that Mercedes garage will play it safe. but I think there'll be carnage almost everywhere else in that Grand Prix. I've gone with a Sebastian Vettel second place, which I know is crazy, but hey, I'm in a crazy mood today. Carlos Sainz, P3, Ricciardo at second, fourth place in a row, and Lance Stroll rounding out the top five. Fingers crossed as a race, that carnage. But here is your grid. If you want to throw your predictions in the comment section down below, all you have to do is follow this format. Pole position, front row and biggest shot from qualifying, winner, your podium, first retirement, driver of the day, and best of the rest. We're kind of categorizing best of the rest at the moment in that kind of behind the two Mercedes and the two Red Bull cars. Though I suppose if you want to throw an Alex Albon, you can do. So maybe that fourth place spot is what we'll go with. So that is your grid to follow if you want to be featured in tomorrow's video. Before we go, Fantasy League time. If you haven't yet joined, there is still more and more of you joining every single time. We're almost up to 4,000 of you. And finally, I've jumped into the top 1,000 after an awesome British Grand Prix for my team. I put in Gasly in replace of Perez in the final few moments. He's back this weekend, and I've made Lewis Hamilton my mega driver. I didn't actually know I could do that. So if you've not done it for one of your drivers, I think this could be a good weekend to make Hamilton your mega driver. And of course, as I always do each weekend, this is what your schedule looks like. So mobile users, laptop users, feel free to screenshot your screen right now. Everything this weekend is pushed back an hour. So the race this time out is 10 past 3. Last week, it was 10 past 2. So if that's a little bit easier for you, there it is. Qualifying on Saturday at 3 o'clock, the feature race for Formula 2, 4:45. That's going to be quite fun. And again, the race at 10 past 3 on Sunday. And that is it for your preview for the Formula One 70th anniversary Grand Prix. It's a real mouthful, but I think we'll get used to it over the weekend. As always, if you are new around here and you enjoyed today's video, of course, drop a like. It really helps out the channel. But if you want to keep up to date with all Formula One 2020 news reviews, all that good stuff, subscribe button is down below. Thank you all very much for watching. Enjoy the racing this weekend, and hope to see you all in the next one.